Welcome to my video of how to build a microserver. So, we're going to build a New Horizons server. I've of course already made it, but I will show you guys how to make a microserver. So, first we're going to choose this one. Then you get to this panel. Here you have start, stop and restart. The name of your microserver, server ID, slots you can increase or decrease that. The max is for me right now 40, but of course I will increase that if there comes a demand for it. So server address, ports, world, this is the name of your microworld, and the server type. You can choose a server type, do anything you want, but I use a Forge 1.7.10. So I will use custom. I will show you how to do that. Chat, here you can go into the chat of your server. Console, you can use console commands in this if you know how to use them. Player data, I can show you that. That's me. Your files, your config files, that you can edit your server properties. Plugin list, I use Forge, so I don't need this right now, but you, if you use any other source, you can pick one to install it much easier into it. Then you have VHP file access. This is the most important one, because here you can go inside your server. See? There you can also add mods and other stuff. Your ports, that's really important for the program I use, FileZilla, so I can manage my server much easier and add and delete stuff. Advanced settings, so as you can install commands, schedule tasks, it will then repeatedly, or you can schedule a command, user, and this one's not really important. But first, we're going to download Minecraft Forge. I have already downloaded, but if you haven't, do it. And then open it and install it to your desktop. I've already done that. So, next, what we're gonna do is going to install FileZilla. FileZilla is the program I use to manage it. You have the host, username, password, port. You have to install that so you can connect to your server. So as I have showed you already, if you don't know how to do it, go to files, go to VHP file access and add the data that is here, VHP address, port, username, password. It's really simple. The host, you will use the VHP address, your username, your password, your port. Then you go to quick connect. I've already done that, but still I have Forge 1.7.10. And ta-da, here is our server. So every change we make here will be shown in your Shockwave VHP file access. So this is done. This we won't need right now. But first we're going to edit our Minecraft Forge. So as you see here, I have Forge install, mods, and world. I will show you every one of them, so don't worry. First, we're going to forge. You have these three files. What we have to do is change the universal jar to custom, because this one will be our server type. So change name to custom, no caps. Ta-da. Done. We're going to add these three to your FileZilla. So what we're gonna do is this here, grab our FileZilla, then we're going to add these two inside the map. Then it will load in here. Important one is you upload all of them, otherwise it will crash, it won't work. So this will take, you can see here, the fast upload, is it failed to upload, you can see here, and also why. It is finished, you can see here, and you get a notification if you have turned it on. In the wait a bit, so it's done. It has uploaded into our Minecraft server. I don't know why it didn't show, but I have now uploaded my files, and I will show you right now what happens next. I once again go to my VTP files, access, and you see it has been uploaded, every one of them. Now, if we're going to our server, I've added custom, going to do start. The first time you start up, it will take a few seconds and minutes. I'm going to console, and you see it will start the region. And we have made our server work. So if you right now use your server address, then you will see it. So we have installed our Minecraft server, and now we're going to look if it has worked, if we have done the things so as my instructions. And here it is. Sorry. So here it is. Test server proto. It always takes a while. And here it is, and we have done it. the Minecraft server works, and we're in. You started in default server, default game mode. You can edit that in your server properties, but it worked. That is what we wanted to know. So right now it works. So the next step will be how can we succeed in getting our mods? I use these mods, I will be putting them in the description below. What you have to do is in your server, your shop byte, see, we also now have world, player information, and mods. So what we're gonna do is right now all our maps that we need have been created, so we're going to FileZilla. There we have the mods file. You click on that, it is empty, but we're going to fill it because I already have a mod folder. I'm going to add a mod folder to the FileZilla. Very important in this step, when we're going to have to allow the mods to work, going to have to restart the server. We're going to add it to each other. Then we see in the preview that is loading, and now I use a lot of mods, but otherwise my world won't work. And it's adding, and it's done. Now we added the mods, and the mods will work if we have done it right. So right now we're going back to our Minecraft server, and because we added mods, we're going to stop the server. Then we're going to start the server. And yes, the mods you put in the server has to be the same as the mods you have in your client folder. Otherwise, the mods won't work, or you will see things you are supposed to, you can't see, and your Minecraft crashes. It happens a lot. And that is on. Now we have successfully added the mods. And you can see on. Alright, we did install the mods a couple of minutes ago, and now we're going to look if it worked. So So we're going inside. So we've installed our mods, they are working. So right now we're going to add our world. So what you're gonna do is you're going to add your world. You can get your world form the roadmap that is in your save. If you want to go to your save, use this app data and you see your Minecraft. Can you go to saves and world? I've already done that. Here a thing that you do just add role to this page again and then it will override your world. Once you have done that, you're going to open this and you're going to restart it again. And then, if it's get a green thingy, the green OK, then you know your server is active. If you have any questions, don't be scared to ask me. And that's how you add your world. Right now, we're going to in the Minecraft server to see if it worked. So, see you then.
And this fellow is Mickey Mouse.
Yeah, no thanks on the heirloom or the crossword guys. Let's just keep it simple.
Hey, relax. You're awesome.
Alright. So, right now we're inside the server where we just have uploaded our world to. Sorry, it's a bit laggy, but you'll have to do with it. As you see, this is Trista inside the New Horizon server. And no, you can't fly at the beginning. It's just an for now. You see, everything works. Hey Shanna, hey Barney. How is Barney? You also have Boxwell, but as you can see, it all works. I hope you got anything wiser. If you have questions, just ask in the comments. And I will help the best I can. Thank you for watching. Subscribe, and if you want to see more, next video I will be building in survival. We will be working on the magic school. It's a very big project right now and it will be a lot of work. Subscribe and follow my new Instagram account. I will put a link in the description below. Yes, thank you for watching.